हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज पूनम दंडारे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ तुलसीराम जी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग टेक्नोलॉजी नागपुर। इन दिस सेशन वी हैव टू सी द जावा कंस्ट्रक्टर एंड जावा मॉडिफायर्स। सो बेसिकली कंस्ट्रक्टर, इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन एनी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज। सो इन जावा कंस्ट्रक्टर इज अ ब्लॉक ऑफ कोड्स सिमिलर टू द मेथड। That means the constructor should be a method. It is a function or it is a method. In Java, we define a class and object. So every method, every function, every attributes, anything you should write in the only class. The class name should be the same as the function name. So it is known as the constructor. So the constructor, it is used to initialize an object of the memory. So a constructor is a block of codes similar to the method. So it is called when an instance of the class is created. At the time of calling constructor, memory for the object is allocated in the memory. So basically a constructor is Java is a special method that is used to initialize the object. The constructor is called when an object of the class is created, and it can be used to set initial values for object attribute. So it is a special type of method which is used to initialize the object. Every time an object is created using the new keyword, at least one constructor is called. So it calls a default constructor if there is no constructor available in the class. In such case, Java compiler provides a default constructor by default. So there are two types of constructor in Java, that is the non-argument constructor, means default constructor, and parameterized constructor, that means we have to pass an argument. So it is a called constructor because it constructor the values at the time of object creation. So it is not necessary to write a constructor for a class. It is because Java compiler creates a default constructor if your class doesn't have any. That means if you do not contain any method, so by default the Java compiler creates a default constructor. So rules for creating Java constructor is, that means there are the two different rules. So constructor name must be the same as its class name. There are some rules in Java constructors, that means constructor name must be same as the its class name. A constructor must have no explicit return type, that means you didn't write void or integer or float. That means constructor doesn't contain the explicit return type. And a Java constructor cannot be abstract, static, final and synchronized. So there are the two types of constructor, that means the no argument constructor, that means the default constructor, and the second one is the parameterized constructor. So a default constructor, that means a constructor is called default constructor when it doesn't have any parameters. So syntax and the program for the default constructor is in the screen. So we have to create a class main and we have to create a class attribute. So we have to construct a class. So that means we have a class constructor, that means the class name should be same as the must be same as its a class name. That means the constructor name must be same as the class name. So the class name is the main and the constructor name is also a main. Then we have to set the value, initial value of the class attribute x, that is the 5. After that we have to wrote the main method. So we have to create the object of the class main, and this will be called the constructor. By default it will be called the constructor, because if you didn't, or if you do not if didn't didn't write the particular constructor or particularly method or any function, so by default the Java compiler call the default constructor. So we have to create the object of the main class, or by using the object we have to, by defaultly we have to call the constructor. So we have to print the value of x. So this is, we didn't pass any arguments, so this is known as the default constructor. So particularly this is the example of default constructor. So note, the constructor names should be must match with the class names, and it cannot have any return type like void. So also note that the constructor is called when the object is created. By default, when we create an object, by default the constructor will be called, and the all classes have constructor by default. If you do not have create any class constructor yourself, Java creates one for you. However, then you are not able to set initial value for the object attributes. Next one is the constructor parameter or parameterized constructor. So constructor which has a specific number of parameter is called a parameterized constructor. That means that means constructor can also take a parameter. By using, we have to pass an argument in a method, we have to pass an argument, so this is known as the constructor parameter. So why use the constructor parameters? So the reason behind is that the parameterized constructor is used to provide different values to distinct objects. However, you can provide the same values also. So this is the example of the particular parameterized constructor. That is, we have to create the class main, we have to pass the particular, we have to create a attribute of a class main, and we have to pass the argument, that is the int y. So particularly x equals to y, so we have to access, we have to pass as an argument. So this is the parameterized constructor. Next, this is the another example of parameterized constructor. We have to pass the two arguments like year and the model name, that is, these are the two car attributes. So this is the particularly parameterized constructor. Next is the Java modifier. So in Java there are the some access specifier, but now onwards we have to call them as a modifier, because these are the modifiers. They just do the modification in the program. That is, there are the two types of modifier. One is the access modifier and second is the non-access modifier. Access modifier controls the access level, and non-access modifier do not control access level but provides some other functionality. So these are the some access modifier. Public and default are the classes, it is used for the classes. That means the public, if you write the any class as a public, that means the class is accessible by any other class. And if it is a default, the class is only accessible by classes in the same package. So this is used when you don't specify a modifier. And for the attributes, method and constructor, there are the four different types of access specifier: public, private, default and protected. These are the non-access modifier. Final and abstract are the non-access modifier. Final is the keyword, that is, it is a constant, means you can't access outside the class. If any function or any class, you have to just write here a final, declare as a final, so you can't access outside the class. Same as for the abstract class. So for the attribute and methods, final, static, abstract, transient, synchronized, volatile, these are the some different attributes. Next one is the final. So if you don't want to ability the override existing attribute values, so declare attribute as a final. That is, the final is a constant value. That means the if any variable, any function you declared as a final, that means you can't change or you can't modify that values in the whole program. So if you don't want the ability to override the existing attribute value, so declare that attributes or function as a final. Next, static. A static method means that it can be accessed without creating an object of the class. In previous lecture, we already covered the static and non-static functions. These are the some access specifier of this Java modifier. So in onwards, we didn't call that is this is the access specifier. These are the modifiers. That means these are the Java modifiers. So thank you so much.